कृषी विपणन आणि रोगासंबंधित माहितीपूर्ण व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी कॉटन गुरु यूट्यूब चॅनल सबस्क्राइब करा आणि नवीन व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी बेल आयकॉनवर क्लिक करा.
इनवाइट द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर कैलाशी लालपुरिया, सीईओ एंड डायरेक्टर ऑफ इंडोकाउंट इंडस्ट्रीज लिमिटेड. मोस्ट वेलकम कैलाशी.
थैंक यू महेश भाई फॉर इनवाइटिंग अस ऑन दिस वंडरफुल प्लेटफॉर्म. हैप्पी वर्ल्ड कॉटन डे. This is my second opportunity to be with you on this wonderful day.
Right. Last year also you had shared your wonderful views, and most of the speakers had shared views, and there were a lot of good comments on that we have gained a lot, and some insights on the new upcoming season. The timing is appropriate because the new Indian season starts very shortly. And Kailashi, the question that we have come up for you is vision of a textile corporate brand for organic cotton. All said and done, your stakes are so high. You are an integrated company, you are a brand, you are a corporate. So what are you looking at, today, tomorrow, or day after tomorrow, as far as organic cotton and an organic sustainable supply chain is concerned? Please share your thoughts.
Yeah, see, first of all, two important comments which you made, the socio-economic impact is very dear to us as a corporate company. And finally, we are arriving at the ESG stage. You see, there was financial reporting of the company which used to be lauded. Today, in this world, ESG has become much more important than the financial world, that is environmental, social, and the governance part. So I think the climatic changes which has happened are really very severe on the world. And these disruptions which are happening has a huge cost. And particularly, if we recognize this fact that it is severe on the farmers and the underprivileged more, which forms almost 70% of our population as a country. Right. So I think the environmental consciousness which has now come up to the fore, I think this will enforce the corporate world to go back to the roots, like get connected to the farmers and to the cotton world. So I think this is an important area which we all should recognize. And as you must be hearing that the health, hygiene and wellness segment is slowly becoming much more popular in all products, whether it is food, whether it is clothing, whether it is, LEED certified building or whatever you do, you have to keep environmental consciousness in mind. So that's the reason you see as a risk management, companies have to evolve and grasp this and absorb this ESG in their DNA. So I think this is a wonderful opportunity for us. We do produce a large amount of organic cotton to the world. And I think this should be taken as an opportunity to further enhance, the cultivation of organic cotton. Now, God's, has given us a wonderful opportunity to understand, what are the regulations, what are the policies, what are the formulations to, grow cotton, on a particular platform. And we have all learned from it. But why not we form an organic exchange for India? There are certain rules and regulations which are unique to our country. So we should surely form, because we are an important player in organic cotton within the country, and the corporate should come forward for contract farming, for a structural growth. We have this opportunity. So on this platform, I would suggest that, we should form an organic cotton exchange of our own. We should learn from gods, take their help in recognizing this and forming this, so that our farmers also get a platform to not only improve their yield and the process and the systems, but to get to know the world. And through this, I think we will be able to build a brand as well, because there is no brand. This brand equity needs to be built. It should not be treated as a commodity, because as we move forward, as we urbanize, the land will become much more expensive. So I think the farmers has to someday, you know, withdraw to certain extent, which we should not let it happen. Because see, cotton is a wonderful opportunity for us in the world because we are the largest producer of both organic and Indian cotton. And we should initiate this branding exercise and brand it. And this can be built with the help of corporate. We as a company has also initiated Gagan, like a project which is a sustainable cotton initiative, tying up with 4,000 farmers to see how we can bring awareness into how better cotton can be grown, like BCI cotton. And what Sanjay ji mentioned has suddenly become the order of the day and it has gained importance. So I think we need to have a collective approach as a country, as corporates, as citizens, and embrace these organic processes, systems, and instill that into the larger class of farmers, you know, growing cotton. Thereby, you know, that brand equity can be developed for all the stakeholders. So I think with this message, I would like to say that there should be a collective approach for the corporates to come forward and let the industry also grow. But at the same time, the environment also should be protected. The natural resources also should be protected. And there should be minimal, you know, environmental and emissions issues which should be addressed, you know, jointly, so that, you know, we can all survive in the survive this world. So with this message, I think I once again congratulate Cotton Group for all these initiatives, all these years, and particularly Manish ji Daga for taking, you know, such initiatives, getting closer to the farmers is a very exciting thing to see and learn from him, that how, you know, he is trying to help them, you know, grow particularly the cotton in different ways and to really go after, you know, the organic ways of growing cotton. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kailash ji, and thank you for your kind words again.